Ever wondered what the portfolios of the richest people in the world look like? If you're watching this video, then the answer is probably yes. What would you say if we told you it's not that hard to see what someone like Bill Gates is investing in? Bill Gates is currently worth more than $130 billion, and any investor who manages more than $100 million is required to file what's called a Form 13F with the SEC. Since anything filed with the SEC falls under the Freedom of Information Act, you've got yourself a window through which to see what stocks Mr. Gates is interested in at the end of each quarter. Now, without further ado, let's give you a deep dive into the top 10 holdings in Mr. Bill Gates' stock portfolio. Just to keep things interesting, I'm saving the top spot for last to keep the suspense up. Gates pick number 10, FedEx Corp. Last year was difficult across the board because of COVID lockdowns. However, FedEx and other parcel carriers picked up the torch and kept the world running when no one truly knew what was going to happen. Now, with e-commerce set to shatter any standing records, FedEx stands to continue to innovate and meet the needs of not only their customers, but also their shareholders. While growth may be slow and steady in a market with very high overhead, the steady dividend growth since 2014 may put FedEx square in the sights of dividend heroes. Gates currently holds just shy of 1.5 million shares, representing 1.87% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 9, Schrödinger Inc. Schrödinger is a software company, but you've probably never heard of them before. They provide software for clinical research that allows for modeling of compounds and molecules. The software and services offered by Schrödinger are used by biotech companies, universities, and governments. After getting a vaccine to market quicker than most people ever thought possible, you can bet that companies like Schrödinger, whose software was part of that effort, are going to receive more attention in the near future. Gates currently holds almost 7 million shares, representing 2.21% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 8, United Parcel Service Inc. The story with UPS is almost the same as it was with FedEx. So why would Gates put more of his money on their success than their competitor? In a market where you have a direct and almost evenly matched competitor, every little competitive advantage helps. Here's one analysis of efficiency driving success from a recent Fast Money interview.
And this really was sort of a, you know, they showed FedEx how it's done. Nice, very nice job. They didn't ship more packages, but they made more revenue on each package that they shipped. Their mix was better. They didn't have those employee problems that FedEx seemed to have, the labor shortage that FedEx had that really dragged down their quarter. Remember, UPS is union, FedEx is not. So there was a lot to like here.
In the case of UPS, the company grew at nearly twice the pace of FedEx over a three-year period from 2017 to 2020. While only Gates and his investment managers really know the reasons, it's clear that UPS is viewed as having an edge in the courier market. Gates currently holds 2.8 million shares of UPS, representing 2.44% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 7, Ecolab Inc. Most people who follow Bill Gates' work, and even those who don't, know that he's heavily involved in helping to eradicate infections and diseases, sometimes pumping billions into such efforts. Ecolab is on his portfolio list for this reason, since they develop technologies and services to help treat water and improve hygiene around the world. Short term, the stock is slightly high, but the fundamentals point to a strong company with plenty of cash to drive growth. Gates invests his money very similarly to Warren Buffett, so while some might be saying Ecolab is a bit overbought, Gates is in it for the long term. Gates currently holds over 4.3 million shares, representing 3.77% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 6, Crown Castle International Corp. Do you truly understand what an REIT is? If you don't, then you should know that while an REIT certainly includes companies that hold houses, office buildings, and other real estate assets, an REIT can also be heavily involved in the communications network, specifically cell towers. Cell towers are a bit like the tollways of the communications sector, and companies like Crown Castle specialize in building and maintaining cell towers to support the cell phones everyone carries in their pocket. Gates obviously sees the potential in this market since he holds over 5 million shares, representing 4.16% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 5, Walmart Inc. Walmart is a powerhouse of retail. It used to be one of the biggest names in retail until Amazon pushed e-commerce into the spotlight. While e-commerce is certainly the way of the future, Walmart is still ubiquitous, and brick and mortar still stands as a necessity for many consumers. While their core business still breaks records, Walmart is building its e-store to at least put up a fight against Amazon's might. There is certainly some work to be done to catch up with the e-store power of Amazon. Though in the short term, holiday forecasts for 2021 are pointing to record sales, especially for Walmart. Gates currently holds 7.6 million shares, representing about 4.5% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 4, Canadian National Railway Co. It's easy to picture those old money barons in Newport mansions that built their wealth on railroads. but there's a very good reason for that. Having the family money from it is one thing, but holding stock in railroads is almost as good. It's a slow but steady way to make money, but Gates is the largest single shareholder of Canadian National Stock, ticker symbol CNI. Now that global supply chains are showing signs of strain, the future of railroads will be tied up in driving efficiency, not only of capital, but also of logistics. Dividends may suffer as a result of the need for this efficiency, but the Gates Foundation still holds a strong position in CNI. Gates currently holds almost 14 million shares, representing a bit over 6% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 3, Caterpillar Inc. Civilization in its various forms continues to spread throughout the world, and a large portion of this growth is physically done with a caterpillar machine. CAT's growth was driven by the legendary growth of China in the last 20 years. While growth took a hit during 2020 and, according to some analysts, may take a hit after the dust settles from the Evergrande situation, CAT continues to thrive wherever infrastructure expansion is needed. The move towards more autonomous technology and lowering carbon emissions makes Caterpillar an impressive company for the future. Capital growth is expected, as are strong dividend payments to shareholders, which might help explain why it is Gates' third largest holding at 10 million shares, representing 9% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 2, Waste Management Inc. As the second largest allocation in his stock portfolio, waste management is an obvious choice in line with Gates' environmental efforts. Gates doesn't invest unless there is some upside, however. Waste management is in the enviable position of having strength in a market that few others can break into due to the high entry costs and regulatory roadblocks. The efficiencies used to keep our cities clean help drive profits to research new ways to get rid of waste. Gates' holding is huge, with over 18 million shares representing almost 11% of his stock portfolio. Gates pick number 1, Berkshire Hathaway Inc. Warren Buffett and Bill Gates have been friends for a long time. Gates was, in fact, a member of the board of Berkshire Hathaway, so it makes sense that he would hold some shares of one of the highest-priced stocks on the market. At $430,000 per share, the stock price reflects the value of having direct insight from the Oracle of Omaha himself at the famous shareholder meetings. Here's Gates talking with Buffett about how they met, but specifically, how Warren is able to simplify complex finance concepts.
Yeah, two things that I picked up after meeting you, bridge was one and golf was another. I was never a good golfer, and it was an excuse to talk. It certainly wasn't about golfing. Whenever I see something, you know, take these very low interest rates, even negative interest rates, I'm always thinking, boy, I'm looking forward to talking to Warren about that.
Gates holds over 43 million shares of Berkshire Hathaway Class B shares, which do not have voting rights and are priced more reasonably at $286 per share. The trust in the greatest investor of all time is still strong, and it's the reason that it takes the top spot in Gates' stock portfolio. It's important to remember that, while still not even remotely chump change, Gates' stock portfolio only represents about $30 billion of his vast fortune. The remainder of it is tied up in Cascade Investments, which is the holding company he created after selling his shares in Microsoft. If you want to mimic some of these positions, it's certainly worth your time to research what the companies do and how they're positioned to succeed in the future. This is especially true if you have a desire to invest in environmental initiatives and companies with a good reputation. His recent personal issues notwithstanding, Gates still values companies with excellent management above all, having led one of the best companies in the world himself.